Hey, hello, and welcome to a new reaction video. My name is Herr Buddha, and I'm so happy that you clicked on this video. Many people in my comments asked for a reaction on henna colors, and this was the first one I saw on YouTube. I don't know what went wrong, but it's saying dyeing my hair with turmeric, and it says fail. Turmeric, I don't know, it's a brand. We're going to see it together, but henna colors are really difficult. Difficult to color and really difficult to get it out. If you have henna colors, you cannot bleach on henna colors. But first, we're going to see a hair fail of henna colors because I have something to say about these henna colors so they can help you at home. But before we start, can I please ask you to subscribe to my channel, press that notification bell. You can follow me on Instagram and you can also follow me on TikTok. I'm going to ask you to go to the channel of Natalie Nielsen because that is the video that we are going to see. The video is on the channel of Natalie Nielsen. Go to her channel, subscribe to her channel. Every YouTuber is always trying to get to 1,000 subscribers, then the next one is 10,000 subscribers, then you have a long way to go to 100,000, and I'm nearly there. So thank you everybody for subscribing to my channel because I'm nearly at 100,000 subscribers. I'm so happy and I want to thank everybody. Just one question before I start. I have a passion of traveling, and I normally I have a YouTube channel with my family. It's in Dutch, so I cannot put them on my channel, but I made some small videos just with music of our travels, and it's traveling through America, Africa, Europe. So I'm asking to you if it's okay that now and then I will put a travel video, a small clip, 3-4 minutes, on my YouTube channel, or are you saying, no, I'm here for the hair fails, I don't want to see travel videos. Which one is it? Can I put some travel videos on top of it on my channel so you'll be entertained and maybe you will see some new inspiration for your next traveling if we can travel again after the coronavirus? Or do you say, no travel videos, I will unsubscribe, I will leave your channel. I only want to see the hair fails. So also put it in the comment. I want to know travel videos as an extra, not every week, but now and then as an extra or not at all. 2 years ago or maybe 1 year ago, I don't know, before I did the hair fails, I put it some travel videos. So you can check them out there. If you are go to my channel, it's, I think, really in the bottom of my channel, some travel videos. So if you want to see them, you can check them out. Enough said, let's go to the video of Natalie Nielsen.
Hello, today I am gonna be dyeing my hair with the kitchen spice called turmeric or gurkemeie in Norwegian.
Kitchen spice?
I have seen a couple of people do this already, like years ago, but I haven't seen anyone do it on already orange / gingery red hair. So I'm gonna be testing this out on this hair color to see if I can bring it to a bit more of a yellowy orangey tint. So I'm just gonna change my top and let's get started. My oh so fine hair dye t-shirt, because you shouldn't wear a t-shirt that you care about. If there's one thing I've learned from watching Get Up With The Owls, it's that you should wear gloves and wear a t-shirt you don't care about. And also, coffee. What I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna take this entire spice thingy and I'm just gonna...
It's powder.
Be careful when opening it. This it stains everything, just
It is really on your skin.
A fair warning.
On your floor.
Should I just do it all? Okay, so I'm leaving just like the tiniest bit. So almost an entire box in a box. And then I'm just gonna take some conditioner. This is just like really cheap conditioner.
Conditioner? Why? Why conditioner?
I'm gonna remove my watch because I don't want my watch to get wet and yellow.
I don't think this is really a henna color, but henna powder is going way back in history. The Egyptian used henna color or herbs or whatever to color their hair. So if you want to use the pure henna powder, it always has to be mixed with water. Just boiled water, hot water. If you're mixing together, you have some kind of mud. This mud is applied on your hair. It's not only coloring slightly your hair, but it's also a good treatment for your scalp. It's like a packaging, a mud packaging, like you have a mud packaging on your scalp, on your body. That's also a thing that you can do on your scalp. We did that also in my salon for an extra treatment. But the real henna color is red, pure red. So if you're coloring your hair with henna powder, it will be reddish. It will not say that it will be pure red, because henna is not a hair dye. Henna will color your hair with its natural pigments. So if you have blonde hair, it will be more bright red. If you have dark brown or nearly black, you will see nothing. Henna cannot lift your hair up, it cannot make it blonde, it cannot go darker, and it cannot change your hair. So henna is using your tone to make a color. The brand that we are working with is Philip Martens. It's an Italian brand, and it has a lot of henna powders that are mixed with coffee, with other herbs. But every henna color is warm. It will always be orange, reddish, goldish. It will always be warm. Cold colors like ash, it's not existing in henna. It's not. So if you can buy a henna color in the store and you have to mix it with a cream, now I see she's mixing with a conditioner. I don't know why, I never seen that, but always has to be mixed with hot water. It has to boil, and then you have to mix it, and then when it's less hot, you can apply it, but you have to apply it very quickly, because if it's coming cold, it has to be warm. You have to put heat on top of it, but it cannot dry out. If you buy a henna product in a packaging and you have to mix it with a cream developer, then it's not henna color. It's a box dye with maybe henna powder inside, but it's not mixing with cream. Like I see it in many supermarkets, henna color with a developer. It's not possible. You cannot go to blonde with henna. You cannot go to dark or brown, or it cannot change your hair. It can only change the character of your hair. So this is important. Many times I see that I color my hair with henna. It's not henna. It has to, if it's lightening up your hair, it's not henna. Not. So and when I say you have to heat it up, it has to be heated, but also you have to damp it with water constantly. Constantly. If it dries out, it stops working. And you have to leave it for 1 hour, 1 hour and a half, and make it moisturizing. Otherwise, it stops working, like with bleach. That's the same thing. Coloring your hair with henna, it takes a lot of work. It's really, really, really dirty, because it's really mud and it falls on your floor. It's a stain on your floor. It's really messy. It's really messy. So let's see how she applied the mud.
These are just some leftover gloves from another time that I dyed my hair. So this could potentially stain your skin through the gloves. So careful. It's probably gonna stain all of my skin. All of a sudden, this doesn't seem like such a smart idea anymore. I see you, Joanna. Oh, this is harder than I expected. I'll need a heck of a lot of conditioner. Just a pro tip.
To comb your hair before doing this.
So messy. I wanna die. I guess I'm just gonna take some of this and do like this. Really, if you made it this far, you really shouldn't do this. You really just shouldn't. Just don't do it. It's not gonna be good for your soul. I'm telling you now, just don't. Look at this. Looks like someone just shat all over my bathroom. I hate this. Look at this. It's not even sticking. I want to go back to bed.
A waste of time and money. A waste of perfectly good conditioner. A waste of basically a whole packet of kitchen supplies. A waste of perfectly good patience. But I'm not patient anymore. This is so hard and so messy and gross.
My hair is feeling like shit. There is turmeric dye everywhere and my entire bathroom is yellow. So what I'm trying to say is it's a really good way if you want to dye your bathroom. But other than that, you should keep kitchen spices in your kitchen. Okay, so this is what my bathroom looks like right now. And my bathroom looks like this.
Oh my god.
This is the towel I have on my lap. It's not exactly white anymore. I'm probably gonna leave this on for about an hour. So I'm just gonna leave it on for an hour and then I'm gonna wash it out and then I'll be back and we'll see how it turned out.
Oh, look at the stains.
This is... it's been a couple of hours since I did the thing, but I washed it out and honestly it didn't really do, it did practically nothing. It's not really visible except it stained my scalp yellow and my nails look horrible. And it's not dry because my hair takes a million and 2 years to dry, but it feels really nice. So I guess it's like an effective hair mask, but it's, I don't recommend it because it exacts and you have to clean your entire bathroom afterwards. But yeah, I did that and I hope you liked this video and thank you guys so much for watching and I'll see you next time. Bye!
So you saw the difficulty of applying the mud. It's really a mud stain on your scalp and you have to apply it very thick, more thick than she did. So you have to make it a really big ball of mud, henna mud, and then apply it, and it has to be really, it's really heavy on your, the clients of me were always telling it's so heavy. If you do it like that, it's like falling over. It's really heavy and you have to make it wet. And she said before, it's not damaging. No, it's not damaging because it's just powder and hot water. If you have to mix it with a developer, it's not pure henna anymore. Has some henna in it, but it's not a real pure henna color. She was too dark for this light color to change because there's no developer. So, but you saw it on the regrowth and the scalp and the little hairs in the front that was really yellow. For a hair mask, for a skin treatment, it's really, really good, the henna powders. But don't expect very big changes if you are using a pure, real henna color. If you see box dye in the supermarket, it says henna, it will not be henna. If you see a powder, just powder, then you can buy it. That's a real henna. But don't expect real chains unless you are blonde. And then you will be orange, yellow, blonde. It will not be ash. Not. And it fades really quickly. If you want to have a henna color that stays longer, you have to build it up. In 2 weeks, you have to do it again. And in 2 weeks, you have to do it again. You have to do 3 henna colors to stain, to maintain long. So you have to have a buildup. So that's also really important. But if you have real henna pigments inside your head, it's really difficult to take them out. So that's also something you have in mind. If you say, oh, I want to have a henna treatment on my blonde hair, it's yellow, and you say, I don't like it, I want to have an ash color, and you will try to take it out, think again. So, have you learned from this video? Please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, press that notification bell, and all I'm going to say today is, ciao kus!